History has shown that the longer we ignore a threat, the more dangerous that threat becomes. Today, I am announcing our strategy, along with several major steps we are taking to confront the Iranian regime's hostile actions and to ensure that Iran never, and I mean never, acquires a nuclear weapon.
Nuclear weapon.
Nuclear weapon.
Nuclear weapon.
He's got him. He's got him. He's got him.
Weapons of mass destruction.
I'm going to repeat what the leader of the Islamic Revolution has said. America can't do a damn thing. America bombards Iran with heavy sanctions. Iran stops producing its own goods. Then America invades its neighbor Afghanistan, followed by its other neighbor, Iraq. Then in Obama's administration, you tried bargaining your way in. You, America, created and funded Daesh to act as a proxy against Iran and its allies. Meanwhile, flooding Saudi Arabia with the biggest arms deal in American history. When all else failed, what do? You fall back on that good old American saying, they've got nuclear weapons, therefore we need to go and fight them. I'm just waiting for you to say, they need democracy. The world is wise to your schemes, you ignorant stuck-up buffoon.
Our policy is based on a clear-eyed assessment of the Iranian dictatorship.
Here we go. You know, coming from a man who didn't even win the popular vote in his own country, that's pretty rich. The Democrat outpaced you by almost 2.9 million votes. That's 48.2% to your 46.1%. And that's only taking into consideration those in the country who actually did vote. All in all, only a quarter of the country actually voted for you, and you have the nerve to turn around and call somebody else a dictator?
Its sponsorship of terrorism and its continuing aggression in the Middle East and all around the world.
Yes, absolutely right, because Iran funded Daesh terrorists, formerly known as the Moderate Rebels of Syria. It was Iran that invaded Iraq in 2003, leading to the ruined lives of millions upon millions of people. It's Iran which has been bombing Afghanistan and Pakistan, leading to the death of over 149,000 people since 2001. And let's not forget, it was Iran which had a hand in global conflicts and wars throughout the globe, such as Vietnam, Panama, Kosovo, Haiti, Cuba, the Dominican Republic, Lebanon. The list just goes on and on and on. I mean, clearly Iran is just a disgrace. I mean, it's been filling the world with bloodshed, chaos, and mayhem since its inception, and it has the audacity and the nerve to point the finger at somebody else and call them the aggressors. Wait a second. That's not Iran. That's the USA! In fact, since 1776, the US has been involved, directly or indirectly, in armed conflicts, war and aggression for 224 years. That means it's given the world a grand total of 17 years of peace out of 241 years of its existence. And then it points the finger at Iran, which hasn't invaded another country in the modern era at all. But don't take it from me. University of Michigan professor and polemicist Juan Cole has said Iran has not launched an aggressive war in modern history, unlike the US or Israel. So who's the real aggressor?
Iran is under the control of a fanatical regime that seized power in 1979 and forced a proud people to submit to its extremist rule.
I think what you meant to say there, Mr. Trump, was that in 1979, the proud people of Iran rose up and overthrew the Shah, who was nothing but a puppet who was strategically placed in Iran to force the people to submit to America's fanatical world government dictatorship. And by the grace of God, a referendum was held over whether to replace the monarchy with an Islamic Republic. Imam Khomeini called for a massive turnout, and only a very few people opposed the vote. The results show that 98.2% had voted in favor of the Islamic Republic. That's the true will and courage of the people. That's the spirit of those who truly follow Islam and will never submit to humiliation.
This radical regime has raided the wealth of one of the world's oldest and most vibrant nations and spread death, destruction, and chaos all around the globe.
Oh, Mr. Trump, you slimy, pompous entrepreneur, you despicable epitome of the hypocrisy of the United States of America and Western policy. You need to pick up a history book, man. You need to find out how America and Britain got its wealth in the first place. They are the true raiders, pirates, and usurpers of the planet. America was built off the backs of slaves. According to the Transatlantic Slave Trade Database, 12.5 million Africans were shipped to the New World. Innocent people who were snatched from their homes in Africa and used for free labor. America didn't only raid the wealth of other nations, it raided its people. Iran, on the other hand, is depending on its own national resources, which it has every right to use. Unlike America, which from the moment it came into existence, it was an imperialistic, colonial, murderous, rapist state, which grew through massacring others. I mean, let's talk about Christopher Columbus, a man who is hailed by American historians as the proud discoverer of America, presented to American school children like a hero, when in reality he was responsible for the brutal treatment of natives. Taino people of Hispaniola were once rich in gold and cotton, but America wanted it. According to the historian Gonzalo Fernandez, by 1548, just 56 years after Columbus landed, fewer than 500 Tainos were left on the island. That means that at least 249,500 indigenous people were massacred so that America could get its hands on gold and cotton and increase its military strength and dominance. Nothing has changed if you look at the way America invades foreign countries, even in today's world, for economic and worldly gains. Las Cacas records that when he first came to Hispaniola in 1508, there were 60,000 people living on this island, including the Indians, so that from 1494 to 1508, over 3 million people had perished from war, slavery, and the mines. Who in future generations will believe this? You won't believe it, because the same thing is happening today, and you're not believing it. Begin.